Hello, my name is Dr. Vergara. I'm an electrophysiologist and a cardiologist. I've been in town for almost 10 years, and a substantial part of my practice has been here at Sunrise Hospital. In today's virtual seminar, we're going to cover atrial fibrillation, left atrial appendage closure devices, patient selection, benefits of left atrial appendage closure, and procedures and surgery during times of COVID pandemic. Atrial fibrillation is the most common arrhythmia in the United States. It affects close to 3 million people every year. It's associated with an increased risk of ischemic strokes. And historically, the mainstay of therapy to prevent strokes in patients with atrial fibrillation have been blood thinners, in particular warfarin. However, blood thinners have side effects associated with the type of therapy they deliver and bleeding. Luckily, over the last few years, technology has been developed that allows to reduce the risk of strokes associated with atrial fibrillation by occluding the left atrial appendage. Left atrial appendage closure device insertion procedure, or Watchman insertion, is performed in the cardiac electrophysiology lab under general anesthesia. We typically use a cardiac anesthesiologist, part of our structural anesthesia team. These are anesthesiologists with the vast experience in structural cardiac procedures and echocardiogram. The procedure takes between 30 to 60 minutes on average. It's minimally invasive, requiring single vascular access through the femoral vein. The patients selected for this procedure are those who have an elevated risk of stroke based on comorbid conditions. In other words, if assessed by your individual physician, it is felt that they are at a high risk of stroke. And those patients in whom the long-term usage of blood thinners might be contraindicated. The benefit of the procedure is the ability to reduce the long-term risk of stroke without having to take blood thinners long-term. We had great success with the left atrial appendage closure procedure here at Sunrise Hospital. The main benefit from our patients is the ability to live their lives without the fear of bleeding associated with blood thinners and a reduction in the overall risk of strokes. This is a common question that I get from my patients. Typically, they would spend a night in the hospital and will go home the next day. Complete recovery will depend on every patient, but within a few days, most patients are completely recovered, with some minor restrictions for about a week. Another concern we hear from our patients is coming to the hospital for an elective procedure during the COVID-19 pandemic. Here at Sunrise, every patient who presents for a left atrial appendage closure device placement is tested for COVID, and we follow all CDC guidelines and policies to minimize the risk of exposure to our patients. Sunrise Hospital has one of the largest structural cardiac programs in the state, with a dedicated team of physicians, nurses, technicians, as well as the latest equipment, including a cardiac electrophysiology laboratory and a hybrid operating room. We also have a dedicated cardiac ICU where we recover our patients post-procedural period. In closing, today we discussed the possibility of a left atrial appendage closure device to reduce the risk of stroke in patients with non-valvular atrial fibrillation, and the ability to perform those procedures here at Sunrise Hospital. We have several physicians able to implant the device. If you have any questions, please reach out to the hospital where we can direct you to the appropriate physician and team of care. Thank you.